This is Wilman Ziada, New York City-based director and creator of theater, television, and film. And today I am thrilled to be speaking with the amazing actor, dancer, singer, the one and only John Cavaceno. But before we get to our interview, here is a sneak peek at the incredible talent of John.
Shines from you, you wind up like the wreck you hide behind that mask you use. And did you think this fool could never win? Well, look at me, I'm coming back again. I got a taste of love in a simple way. And if you need to know while I'm still standing, you just fade away. Don't you know I'm still standing better than I ever did? Looking like a true survivor, I'm feeling like
Hi, John, how are you?
Hello, I'm doing very well, thank you.
John, I'm so excited that you're joining me today. And I believe you're visiting your old stomping grounds, visiting the youngins and telling them how to make it like you are in this big bad world of the theater.
I'm also doing my best, yeah.
That's amazing. It must be nice to revisit your old stomping grounds, no?
It is, 100%. Actually, they're doing a production of Big Fish right now, directed by Jeff Whiting, and I got to see it last night, and seeing a show at the college you went to and seeing them perform, it's like nostalgia and pride and all the feelings.
Well, John, I wanted to wait for this interview to let you know that Jeff Whiting actually happens to be a mentor of mine and one of my closest friends in New York. I adore him. I adore him so much. Everything that he's done, from his choreography to directing to working with Stroman to opening Open Jar Studios to his Stage Right app. I mean, I adore that man. If you see him, give him, you know, just give him a hug. He's like literally one of my favorite people on the planet Earth. So small world indeed.
Yeah. Wow. That's crazy. Yeah.
Well, you know, that was just me making it about me. But anyway, back to you. I love the fact, John, that you are not only an amazing talent, but that you really went after it right after you graduated. Talk to me about what that transition was like for you, being a graduate and then just going after your dreams.
So I wanted to hit the ground running. I really wanted to graduate and just like really get at it. So once I graduated, I did a summer at Tibbetts Opera House. And I was like, okay, let's do it. We're in it. And then I noticed we did West Side Story and Joseph. And I noticed that like I was like keeping up and doing the thing and really a part of it. But by the end of it, I felt a little like, okay, I'm not sure if, as I try to be a dancer first in the musical theater world, I'm not sure if it's all there. So I submitted to do the Commencement at Broadway Dance Center. And I was like, okay, well, I'm going to graduate from here. Not graduate. I'm going to end this contract, put that on my resume, and then really, really train for that like professional semester. And then just from there, I want to just like, jump right out.
That's amazing, John. But what I also love about what you're talking about, and this is important, I think, for a lot of the young artists out there, that you're about your craft first and foremost, that you weren't going to show and present your best self unless you felt it was going to be your best. So you went back to training. I think that's a really important point that you make.
Honestly, like even now I try to do it. I'm like working, I'm working at FAU Schwartz in Rockefeller Center now. And on my days off, I still like voice lessons. I go to steps. I try to keep it. I really try to keep training as much as I can.
I love it. But even like with your side hustle at FAU Schwartz, at the end of the day, look it, you're dealing with new people every day. You have to, you know, use your improv skills to yes and, to use an improv term, any sort of situation. I'm sure you use that opportunity to continue to fine tool your craft as an actor.
100%. We even, oh my gosh, week someone came in and had a jacket from Jerome Robbins Broadway. And I was like, I have to talk to you. And we had a conversation for like 20 minutes about the industry, and he was a part of that show and what it meant to him. And oh my gosh, it was a wonderful experience.
Well, and also this is what I love about New York, especially, nothing against LA or any of the other big cities. But what I love so much about New York that you will see more and more, John, is that you will never get judgment from anyone for working a side hustle. Because frankly, I have friends with Tony Awards who are working side hustles right now. There's no, because at the end of the day, everything is a part of working on your craft in one way or another, whether it's on the Broadway stage or, and this is what I just love about New York and for you, someone who is obviously so unapologetic about their amazing talent, but also just humble enough to be like, look it, this is where I'm at right now. But when I'm not doing what I need to do to pay the bills, I'm studying and fine-tuning my tools and my tool belt on my craft.
Absolutely. Everything, like one of the best things I've learned is like everything that you can take to put in your craft, take it. Working at FAO, I'm a toy demonstrator. So a lot of it's personality, it's improv, like you said. Yeah, performing 100%. It's look at this product. This is so fun. And like I get commissioned on the product. And without a doubt, like being a performer has helped me in this job immensely.
Well, you're a storyteller. And when you're selling a product, what's the assignment? The assignment is to sell the story in the most truthful, entertaining, authentic way. And that's what you do as an actor, a dancer, a singer. You are selling the story in the most entertaining, authentic, truthful way.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
You just said that. I don't have to repeat you. God bless you. Listen, John, before we end our interview, I want to let everyone know for more on the incredible, incredible John Cavaceno. You can read more about him right below this video. John, if you could give advice to your younger self, what would it be?
I was always hard on myself for not being the most talented. And if there's anything I've learned in my time, the most talented will get things, of course, but the hardest working and the one who shows up every day will usually go farther. Like, talent is great. Many people have talent. Walk into any audition room, talent. You'll see so much of it. But the one who is on time, the one who is there, the one who is off book, head full of ideas, ready to go, that one will keep working.
Amen. And on top of that too, something that you have, John, is kindness. And you can tell it right away. Because look, this industry is too hard to work with people who are only kind. And you have that essence with you. You probably brought up in a great family and they should be very, very proud. Well, John, it is so nice to meet you and I'm happy we're connected now. And hopefully we get to collaborate one day.
Yes. Oh, I'm so looking forward to it.